What a pretty alligator.
Do you know, there was a craze once for keeping baby alligators as pets. The pet shops did a roaring trade. They were imported in thousands. Little baby alligators. Just hatched out. The children loved them. They were just like lizards. With big heads. They were so friendly and playful. And cute. Cuddly. But of course, the ones that survived soon began to grow bigger and become rather awkward to handle, rather on the rough side. Not quite so cute and cuddly. In fact, a nuisance to have around the house. Breaking things, snapping, doing business all over the place. Suddenly there were hundreds of them that nobody knew what to do with. The pet shops didn't want them back again. Lots of those little alligators ended up in the dustbins with their heads chopped off. Others, the lucky ones, ended up in the local zoo. But others, many others, ended up a different way. They went a different way. You see, people discovered there was one extremely simple way of getting rid of a little alligator, so long as you hadn't let him grow too big. You just dropped him down the toilet and pulled the flush. That's right. Drop him in, head first, plop, down he goes. Just like you do every day. He's gone. He's out of sight. He's vanished. He's out of your house. You don't have to think about him anymore. But what if you're the alligator? You haven't just vanished, have you? Where are you? You're in a pipe, being carried along by some water. Pretty soon that water stops and you're stuck in that pipe. You try to crawl along. It's very tight, there's not much air. After a while, maybe hours, some more water comes down and washes you further along. After more hours, maybe days, you're washed out of that pipe and dumped into a larger one, like a tunnel, where there is much more water and mess, and where the movement is faster. You're carried along, swirling, floundering, gasping. But since you're an alligator, you swim pretty well. And then suddenly, one day, splosh, you're gushed out into a great black lake of slime. It's very dark down there in the sewer and very quiet. You swim around desperately trying to find something to get your feet onto, because after all you are not a fish. Perhaps you never do find anything to get your feet onto and you eventually drown. Or perhaps you die of asphyxiation. Or perhaps you just gradually starve to death. But perhaps, perhaps you do find a foothold. You find a resting place, a breathing space. Your eyes grow attuned to the darkness. And perhaps in that particular sewer, there are rats and vermin and dung flies. And you are able to see, chase, catch and eat those rats and vermin and dung flies. You even eat some of what you are floating around in. You exist. You survive. You live. You grow. You learn your way around down there. You know where the rats are. You know where the resting places are. You grow bigger and bigger and bigger. And perhaps one day you become a full-sized alligator. Can you imagine the surprise of the first government sewage inspector that went down there one day and came face to face with a monster alligator? Huh? That man ran faster than he never run before in his life. That man has never been seen again. In some cities, they had to organise teams of experts to go down into those sewers with searchlights and rifles and machine guns to hunt those alligators and kill them, and they did. And now? Baby alligators are no longer permitted to be imported as pets. It's not surprising. But if ever in your life you find yourself down in a sewer and you come face to face with an alligator who blinks at you from the bog, who hates you with all his might, who opens his huge jaws to take you in, you mustn't blame him. Cannot blame that alligator.